How do you do background subtraction? Not so complicated. You have to estimate the background. So at some time t, remember doing x image of x, y, and t, I have to estimate the background. And then I'm going to subtract that background from whatever the current frame is. And wherever the difference is big enough, I'm going to call that my foreground mask. Okay, and it's an absolute difference because the background could be brighter than the thing that's moving or it could be darker. Here's an example, sort of notionally. So here again, same image, right? And this is my estimated background. We'll talk a little bit later about how you might get such a beautiful background. And the idea would be to take your current image, subtract off the background, take the absolute value, and anywhere that it's bigger than the threshold, just output that. All right, fine. But of course, the question is, what's a good estimate of the background? There's a form of background subtraction, which isn't really background subtraction at all, and it's referred to as frame differencing. Frame differencing is exactly what you might think. I'm going to assume that the background is whatever was in the picture just before. Okay, I'm just going to compare the current image to the last image. All right, and background subtraction becomes then I of x, y, and t minus I of x, y, and t minus 1. And if that value is greater than some threshold, I'll output that as my foreground mask. Okay, so here again, two examples. So here's I of x, y, t. Here's this van here. The van has moved a little bit. Let's see, which one's easiest to see that something has actually changed? Oh, here. So you see that this car is moving forward that way, and it's now moved past this line, but at time t minus 1, it was even with that line. Same thing that this van is moving forward. In fact, pay attention to this white van there, okay? I'm going to subtract from this image that background image, and then I'm going to take a look at different thresholds, right? Even before we look at the results, you can just think a little bit about how well will this work. Well, clearly, this is going to depend upon sort of what the objects look like, how fast they're moving, what the frame rate is, the threshold. So, you know, sometimes this is good, and then from the slides I took, you know, it's usually not. Well, and this can be shown here, all right? So if I take different thresholds, so here's threshold of 25, of 50, of 100, and you can see, you know, for this illumination, I don't know, somewhere a threshold somewhere between 50 and 100 seems to be going pretty well. You remember that white van that I told you about? Okay, well, that's right there, okay? So you can see the front of the van, you can see the back of the van, but there's a big hole eaten out of the middle of the van. What happened there? Well, duh, the top of the van was just white, right? Just plain white. So the van tops here, and then in the next frame, it's moved there. So the part where the van was, and now you can see the road behind it, that's a difference. And the part that was road, or the windshield, and now the top of the van there, you can see that, that's a difference. But the middle of the top of that van is white, and if I move it, what does it stay? White, so I don't get much of a difference. Okay, so this is a problem with frame differencing, is that large areas, even as they move, they can move relatively quickly, but if you have large, constant intensity areas, you know, that's just not gonna work very well. So what's a better idea?